Awards Ceremony.
It's a good introduction.
Yep. So now we're going to give out some awards. We have a Brad came up with all the categories, and they're pretty awesome. And we divided them up amongst us three. And I guess we will go one each. Is that how you want to
do? We're going to do it all at once.
Oh, okay. So what's the first category?
Whoever wants to go first.
Oh, okay.
Do you just want to roll, or?
I'll do one first.
No, you do all yours up front.
But we have two categories each.
Yeah, you do all.
Oh, it doesn't matter. Should we do cream of the crop last, since that's like the big one? Like as best guess.
So then we'll
best
do yours last then?
Okay.
Then we'll just roll between me and Nick.
Uh-oh.
Okay, so I got 15, Nick gets 9. So, my two main categories, I have treasure hunting and I have top fives. I'm going to go treasure hunting first since there's more of them. So what I did with mine is I wrote down, I made a cool little sign and I wrote down quotes that we each said at one time. So I'm just going to share those. For treasure hunting, this is a basic overview, some quotes I have. So, treasure hunting this week, said by Brandon. Shuriken, said by me when I ass punched Brandon in the result of a punishment. Nick, wait a sec, I've got some treasure.
Oh man, super monkey ball.
And these aren't exact quotes, these are just what I could remember. And then there's one of mine that says, boom, here's my next treasure, when you were talking about the King of Fighters game. And I had the PC games. And then, laser discs.
Yeah.
Guess I'll be spinning the wheel of punishment. Got any treasure? Ooh, what's that worth? I said by Nick.
The Super Monkey Ball cell.
I actually forgot about it. I just found it in my glove box the other day when I was cleaning it out.
To hold on to it. I know you're genius.
I think I want to play it.
Okay, for worst treasure, here's my quotes first. For worst treasure, here's the quotes. Dude, what is that? Said by Brandon.
What was that referring to?
A lot of things that I brought.
Yeah.
You know, that Star Wars soundtrack still hasn't sold, said by Brandon. So you actually lost money on that? Said by Nick.
What was that in reference
You'll
to?
See.
Oh, okay.
Now this treasure is a little obscure, as said by me.
Oh, yeah.
Multiple times. The nominations are from episode 21, Treasure Trove, Carl's Jr. Bobbleheads, as presented by Brad. From episode 13, Treasure Hunters Gone Wild, Sky Shark by Brandon. Cost $4, worth $1. From episode 16, Achievement, Pokemon cards, brought in by Brad. From episode 17, Dragon Balls, Egyptian Game Kings, and Pocket Monsters, Star Wars soundtrack, and brought in by Brad. And the winner is Sky Shark.
Oh.
Everything else has potential to make money except this one. That's what the... You lost money on that.
Because
we were sitting around saying... You're like... I bought it for $4, but it's worth $1 now. It was worth 86 cents, but it moved up to $1.
Didn't I buy it because I thought we didn't have it or something?
Yeah. We didn't have it.
Yeah.
And you're like, look at the insane look on this guy's face. Next category, most random treasure. Here are the quotes. Psh, a McDonald's toy, said by Brandon. That thing is hecka heavy, as said by me, regards to the Marvin the Martian clock. We're really scraping the bottom of the barrel now, said by Brandon. What? There's a Nazi stamp? Take a look at that spoon. It has some history there. And the nominations are... From episode 41, The Shining versus The Shining. The Venezia Trophy. The McDonald's toy, as brought by Brad. From episode 46, The Ultimate Warrior. The Marvin the Martian clock, which weighed 20 pounds, as brought by Brandon. Episode 16, Achievement. The stamp collection, brought in by Brandon.
That was hecka tight.
Episode 6, The Legacy Begins. The heroin spoon. And from episode 13, Treasure Hunters Gone Wild, Rambo for the Sega Master System. Because you bought it because you liked Rambo. And the winner is the stamp collection.
Yeah, heck of Rambo.
With the Nazi stamp. The swastika.
I've got two wins now.
Yeah, maybe for episode 100 we'll get like little trophies.
That'd be cool.
Funniest treasure. Here are the quotes. Have you ever seen Boxing Helena? I have a surprise injury. Said by Nick. Dude, you have to lay off the sports memorabilia. Said by Brandon. First nominee from episode 42, side-scrolling action, Super Monkey Ball 3D. Found by Nick at the social services office. Some little kid's dreams was broken. Well, or someone's uncle was trying to... Their pawn shop trip didn't go as well.
Now, to be fair, Nick did turn it in and no one claimed it.
That's correct.
Yeah. From episode 6, The Legacy Begins, The Heroin Spoon. Found in episode 16, Achievement, Flashback for the SNES. And this is why it's so funny. Nick said, I love this game. And I said, really? He said, no, I never heard of the fucking game. From episode 21, Treasure Trove, Sports Memorabilia, the Carl Jr. bobbleheads, the Mike Bibby stand with a piece of his jersey. From episode 47, Beast Mode and Soiled Shorts, Laserdisc, because Brandon got excited about the Boxing Helena Laserdisc. And the winner is the Heroin Spoon.
Oh.
Last category for treasure hunting, best treasure. The quotes are, oh, that's hecka tight, as said by one of us, I'm sure. Found at Dimple Arden. Dang, Bry Guy would get a boner off of these. And where did you find that? The nominees are the treasure trove from episode 36, Enter Chris. The Booze Fury, Pokemon Yellow, Pokemon Gold, Pokemon Stadium, all complete with Terminator, X-Men, Shadowrun, and Streets of Rage, found by Brad. Found in multiple episodes, Pokemon Stadium 2, found by both Brad and Brandon. From episode 21, Treasure Trove, Metroid Prime Trilogy, found by Brandon. From episode 20, Bringing Sexy Back, The Treasure Trove, Ogre Battle 64, Conker's Bad Fur Day, Pokemon Yellow, Metroid Alternate Cover, Death Return of Superman, Blackthorn, Super Metroid, and Pokemon Emerald. From episode 37, The Legend of Zelda Skyward Sword Special Edition. And the winner is The Treasure Trove, found in episode 20. The reason why that one won, because that was like the best treasure hunting experience I ever had.
Treasure hunting boner level squirting.
Squirting. So that does it for my nominations for best treasure.
What time is Matty G going to be here?
I didn't know that he was coming.
Oh. Okay, I just assumed.
No.
Okay.
I don't think he's coming.
Okay.
He said he might come after the soccer game, but...
Oh, okay.
Okay, top fives. I have two categories for top fives because I couldn't really say anyone had a worst top five entry because I just didn't think anyone did.
Top five. Not even my Ghosts and Goblins for NES. Top five NES games.
Not even Fresca. Oh. Okay, so we have top fives. Here's some quotes. Here we go, top five, said by Brad and Brandon. Bad dudes, more like bad game, with a solemn face, said by Brad. Hoity-toity, for two big obvious reasons. Our top five this week? Gold dust. You guys are taking liberties with this list.
Who said that?
Nick?
Yeah.
Funniest top five entries. Here are the quotes. No, that's gay. I said by Nick.
When was that?
I think it was during the... I think I have it on
here. Okay.
I do have it on here. And then Fresca. First nomination for funniest top five entry from episode 32, short and sweet. Top five drinks. Brad's entry. Fresca. It's the rebel soda. It goes great with big fish and tilapia. Then Nick chimed in. Or penis.
Can you imagine that? Like, someone gives it a head and then stop, takes a sip of Fresca.
Or someone's listening to that episode about getting a blowjob and there's a can of Fresca in the background. From episode 11, Vegas Baby, top 5 list, top 5 Vegas and gambling movies, mentioned by Brad and Brandon. Brad mentioned The Wizard, Brandon mentioned Rocky IV, then Nick said... You guys are taking liberties with this list. I was debating on including Silver Linings Playbook on here, and that had a hell of a lot more gambling than those other movies. But in Rocky IV, he was gambling with his life. From episode 24, The Man with the Plan, Al Van. Top 5, Spells and Video Games. Nick's entry, Hadouken. Without saying what his entry is, he says... Well, it's kind of a spell. Do you know what ki is? Do you know what it is? And Brandon both said at the same time, the Kamehameha? And Nick said, no, that's gay. All excited. Nick was going to say Dragon Ball. Top 5. From episode 7, Grip It and Rip It. Top 5 favorite wrestlers. Nick's injured. Gold Dust. And the winner is The Wizard and Rocky IV with the assist from Nick. Just to be fair, I could have listed anything in episode 44, but that's coming up. Best top five category is my next nomination. I didn't put quotes on that one. From episode 37, top 5. This is an overall category of what a top 5 was, of a top 5 category. Top 5 Kevin Smith characters and Kevin Smith movie quotes. I nominated this because the impressions we did were spot on. Nick did his Banksy impression, Brandon did his Jay impression, and I did my Brent impression. Episode 32, short and sweet. Drinks. This is why we did the Pepsi challenge. I also got hit in the nuts because I listed too many Coke products. From episode 8, Like a Boss. Top 5 boss battles. We had discussions about Lavos, Mother Brain, Mike Tyson. It was a great episode and a great top 5. Episode 44, Final Fantasy XXX. Top 5 Final Fantasy spells to be used during sex. This is the winner, by far. The best top 5 we've ever done. Everyone had a spot on list. 10 out of 10 in my book. As berserk said by Brandon and Nick. Brandon said, "When for when she says harder and you just can't go harder, you'll show her harder with Berserk." Slow, as mentioned by Brad. Rydia makes sure she gets every last drop. Nick with Float and the Sex Swing. Brad with Dispel. You can't tell me where to come. And Minnie, the midget fetish is mentioned by Nick. And then Edge used that as human dildo. This is by far my favorite top five, and I want to do a lot more like it. So those were my nominations, my categories, and my winners.
Okay, so I guess it's my turn. I have Game of the Week category, and I also have the Punishment category. I guess we'll start with the Game of the Week category. So the first subcategory of Game of the Week would be the easiest Game of the Week. I don't have nominations like Brad does. You guys are more than welcome to chime in and make your own nominees. But I'm doing this category, so I get to make the final judgment. So I ruled that the easiest Game of the Week, and you guys might not agree with this one because it sounded like you guys had a hard time with it, but it was Super Mario Brothers 2, discussed in episode 19.
No, it's all hard.
Why are games based on movies so bad? So, as I was saying, we each had our hand at playing this game, and we tried the Mario Challenge, which was really hard. Basically, the Mario Challenge was to beat Super Mario Brothers 2 using Mario only. Mario just fucking sucks on that game. Heck of hard to even beat one level with Mario on that game. So, I went back to my old tricks. This game is very nostalgic for me. I played it a lot as a kid. I grew to love Luigi from this game because Luigi just had this huge jumping ability. He can jump over basically anything. He's a little difficult to control, but once you get that down, it's a breeze. So I went back to my old tricks. I just beat the whole game with Luigi using the occasional warp here and there. I sent I sent a picture to Brad and Brandon with a Wart going over, being carried by all those little pixie guys, indicating that I'd beaten the game. And when you do that, it shows what character you use throughout the whole game.
Yeah.
I just said Luigi like 20, and everyone else just said 0. Like, how the hell did you do that? I don't know, Luigi's fucking sad. I don't know. So that was my easiest game. I also made an honorable mention. I tried to find the episode where we talked about this, but I couldn't find it. Maniac Mansion. It was one of the first 4 or 5, right?
I think it was episode 6.
Really?
Because we played it before we did it.
Yeah, it was episode 6.
I don't remember. Maybe I just skipped over, but I didn't hear it. So that was an honorable mention for me. It was Maniac Mansion. Do you guys have any other nominations? Well, there are going to be honorable
let me see.
I already made my pick.
Mega Man 2. It's a very easy game for me. It's
blasphemy.
Hold on.
I will not allow that. No, you're right. It is an easy game, but it's too good. But Super Mario Brothers 2 is really good, too.
What are you doing?
I'm looking at something for my list.
Oh.
Did you have anything to add on to easiest games?
Not easiest, no.
No, okay. So, the next category is hardest game of the week. And for this one, I went with the game that we discussed on episode 18, Albums Equal CDs. The game is Mega Man 8. Mega Man 8, I wrote down, Mega Man 8 took the gimmicks from Mega Man 7 and made them much better. The 7 was made for SNES, 8 was made for PlayStation. As much as I love the SNES, there's no debating that, you know, the technology on the PlayStation, the graphics, the feel, it's just better on the PlayStation. The Mega Man 8 was really cool. We discussed this before about how all the characters, the Robot Masters had kind of a character with them. They even talked a little bit and they talked some shit. So that was kind of cool. But what makes this game the hardest, you guys know?
Jump.
Yes! Yeah. Fucking snowboards or hoverboards or whatever the fuck they are. They first show up on Frostman's level, and
Frostman.
But they show up again on the first stage of Wily's Castle. So basically, the game tells you when to jump or when to slide while you're riding on this hoverboard. If you don't do it, you'll fall into a pit or you'll run into a wall. but it's just, it's obnoxious. It gives you this little warning, like maybe a second or two before you have to do it. But it's not enough just to do it. You have to perfectly time it and have to know how far to jump or, you know, make a short jump because another jump's coming right after that. It's just a pain in the ass. So that's why that game was my hardest game of the week, and I didn't have any other honorable mentions. You guys have anything to add to that?
I do. I know it really wasn't a game of the week, but I finally beat Ninja Gaiden.
Nice.
I haven't been able to talk about it on the podcast yet. That's such an awesome moment in my life.
That's tight.
I like to nominate Mega Man X.
As the hardest?
Yeah, only because I didn't do the Hadouken to kill Sigma and his Tiger.
Yeah, okay. If you don't use that, then...
Yeah.
I got up to his third form. He had 4 lives left, and then he killed me. I was like, fuck it. I stopped. I was like... Then I went back and did it with the Hadouken, and it was much easier.
Yeah. I memorized every stage on Ninja Gaiden, and after you beat the boss on level 6, he turns into another boss, and if you die, you go all the way back to 6-1. I was able to get back to the boss in like 4 minutes. And there was no way I was turning that game off. I didn't care if Karen was like, I'm on a divorce. I'd be like, fuck it, I'm going to beat this game. I'll make it up later with my dick.
And I have some Fresca for you, too.
That's like a tie.
Oh, and one last thing is, on the last boss, you fight the giant demon statue, and he throws out little alien tentacles at you, which take away 3 health. And I had him down to 2 health, and I had 3 health left, so 1 more hit of those, and I was dead. And I was like, I'm going to beat him, and I jumped, and I was pushing the cut button, but he wouldn't cut. He was, like, stuck. He, like, wouldn't cut. I was like, what the fuck? So I jumped real quick in and beat him.
Wow.
I was like, if I die, I'm going to be so mad. But I didn't. I stood up and I threw the control and I was like, fuck you, Jack Leo.
Logan's, yeah, fuck you.
And you know, Karen was like, oh, I'm so glad he beat it. You know, I'd be up all night playing that thing until I did.
Alright, so the next category is the lamest. This was discussed multiple times, but it was first mentioned on episode 23, Comic Relief, and it continued as Brandon's Game of the Week for what seemed like months. Tales of Destiny. Man, I heard so much stories about this Bautista character. That's probably why I hate Bautista the wrestler so much, just because I relate that to those two characters. So, Brandon really tried hard to sell this game to me and Brad, but I don't think either of us were buying. We just kind of, you know, went into a little daydream whenever we started talking about Tales of Destiny. Most of the time, you know, we were just zoned out entirely. I think the main character was named Stahn or something like that.
Yes, Stahn.
Oh, fag. But that was the last thing I wrote, was just fuck Stahn. So a couple honorable mentions that I had under the lamest category was Mega Man 7. We just talked about it, how it was I think it might have been one of the first, or maybe one of the only ones released on SNES that was actually part of the Mega Man series, not Mega Man X. Brad said the highlight of this whole game is Mega Man putting on the safety man hat. I entirely agree with that. It just tried way too hard to be different from the other games, and it just didn't need to be. I mean, Mega Man has a tried and true formula. There's no reason to really change it up too much. There's also this store, I think, or there was like a shop that you had to go into.
Yeah.
It was so
And we didn't know how to get into it.
Right. You had to like press the select button or something like that.
On the boss screen, yeah.
But, I mean, there's no way to know that. Maybe in the instruction booklet, I'm sure it probably said that, but if you're just playing it, you know, like you would any other video game, you don't read the instruction booklet or anything like that. You look for little indications on the screen to show you how to get to where you want to go.
Exactly.
I do have to give some props though, because there was a really cool museum in there that featured some old foes from other Mega Man games, like Snake Man, Blizzard Man, Pharaoh Man, Heat Man, Guts Man, Skull Man, and Ring Man. But that made my honorable mention for lamest. Any other honorable mentions from you guys?
That was my nomination, Tales of Destiny.
Yes.
Because I was listening to it when I was doing my research, and Brandon said, hold on. And he grabs his phone and plays a pre-recording. Imagine a world You know, I read the whole introduction on his phone. He couldn't, like, just write it on paper and read it off. Then he had to record it and then put it on the podcast. I was like, man, how long is he going to play? And I know the Tales games are hella long, too. I was like, it's going to be like a 5-month thing.
How far do you think you got in the game? Even though it felt like you played it forever.
I probably completed about 5% of that game.
I'm glad you stopped because I couldn't handle it anymore. Yeah, and then Batista has like Wolverine claws. Is that Batista? Yeah, and then he had like a slave crown.
I was like, that's right. I do remember that part.
Yeah.
Alright, so the last category for Game of the Week is the best game. This was discussed on episode 8 of Like a Boss. It's a game Brandon already, or Brad, excuse me, mentioned as the easiest Mega Man 2. You know, this show is called Treasure Hunting for Nostalgia for a reason, and this is one of the more nostalgic games for Mega Man 2. Discussing the game with you guys was a lot of fun, and listening to Brad explain that he would experience tension in his scrotum any time he had to jump over a pit or avoid enemies was just, it just cracked me up. I appreciated that we all shared the same hatred for the disappearing and reappearing blocks in Heat Man's level. The fear that we all felt when the flying dragon pursued us. And, you know, the intense love that we share for all the Mega Man music, particularly Wily.
Oh, man.
Mega Man 2. And I thought it was really cool that the creators of the game made Bubble Lead the only weapon that you could use to defeat Wily. It was just a kind of cool thing to do. And, of course, the game features the greatest weapon of all Mega Man video games, the Metal Blade. I have a couple of honorable mentions. One of them was a game that you two recommended to me. You listed it as your greatest SNES game of all time, the Lufia 2 Rise of the Sinistrals. I also listed Ogre Battle, March of the Black Queen. Brad was playing that for a while.
For like three
rounds.
Three levels.
Oh, well, I still put it on there. You didn't beat it. I didn't figure that you'd beaten it, but
oh, no.
You did make it your game of the week for a few times. And also, we also played Mega Man X together, which was really cool as well. Anything else you guys want to add on to that?
I had Lufia 2 on the list. Also, Pokemon X, when Brad was describing it to me, and I was like, no way could this be that good of a game. And, oh, man, I was so wrong. And then Mega Man 6. That's where we had all those funny quips about scalping Tomahawk Man.
No drop bomb, no drop bomb. On Yamato Man. And what else is there? No, Centaur Man was part 5, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, that was pretty funny.
I haven't gone back and played that one yet. One of the few that I haven't played. Okay, so the next category is punishments. We'll go ahead and start off with let's see. I guess we'll start off with funniest punishment. The funniest punishment for me, this could definitely be debatable, but it was on episode 25, Lawton Thinks, Torment, Horseradish,
Wasabi. Oh, man.
Gorgon, a.k.a. Alvan, was present for this punishment.
Oh, yeah, he was.
I don't know. I put this idea together. It's not something that I read. I just thought of some nasty shit that it would... that. You know, you could eat, and horseradish and wasabi, pretty gross to put together. So I went ahead and threw it in a bowl and mixed it together and made some sort of like mayonnaise paste looking thing, and it smelled hella gross.
It was all bubbling.
I have no idea how it tastes, and I do not want to know. We got it on YouTube, so if you get a chance, go ahead and search YouTube for that. It's really hilarious. I think it's called Torment's Horseradish Punishment or something like that.
Or you could just subscribe to Nick's channel.
Yeah, do that too. I think my name's like Nicholas Jones or Nick Jones, something like that on there. The way that Brad reacted was heck of funny to me. He turned his head trying to cope with the horrible taste that he was dealing with. He grabbed some towel and he threw up into it. And I don't know how he did it, but he took 2 spoonfuls.
Oh, I forgot about that.
He took 1 spoonful, and I was like, dude, you don't have to take another. It's okay. And he's like, no, I said I was going to do it. So he went ahead and did it. It was so crazy. And then Brandon asked him, was it spicy? Brad said, no! Fucking nastiest shit I ever tasted in my life! So that made my funniest punishment. My honorable mention was another punishment that Torment took on episode 20, Trivia Challenge, Bringing Sexy Back, the Banana Sprite Punishment. Another instance where Brad vomited. So the premise of the punishment was that Brad had to eat two whole bananas and then swig an entire liter of Sprite. I don't remember if it had to be done in a certain amount of time or anything like that. Oh, I think two and a half minutes is how long it took you to eat the bananas. Because I have it on YouTube.
Yeah, it took a heck of a long.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And then it took you 30 seconds to swig the entire bottle of Sprite. I wrote down that you vomited as soon as you put the Sprite down. And there was a little bit of Sprite left in the bottle, and you actually drank it. I was like, I wasn't sure whether you drank it just to like clear the taste out of your mouth or because you wanted to complete the challenge. You
remember that? I wanted to be a man.
that's kind of what I thought. Any other nominations?
The Virgin Corn Dog of Las Vegas.
The Corn Dog of Crisis.
Oh, yes. Man. And then pretty much all of Twisted Shame.
Those weren't punishments, though.
No, they weren't. Felt like it.
Yeah.
Yeah, Twisted Shame was episode 30.
Mm-hmm.
And then you had to kiss Nick's butt for 1 minute. And I think one of the kids that said that it was called What's in the Box. No, yeah. And you and Matt had each a punishment. And they were like, what can we get Brandon to do? Let's have him run around the garage naked. And then Jordan said you had to eat a piece of bologna, and yeah, this was during your vegetarian stage, and you're like, no, I'm not going to do it.
Yeah, that's
and then Logan walked up to you and was like, good job, Brandon.
That was cool.
Yeah, with thumbs up.
That was cool when he did that.
Like, don't try to sell out to Jordan.
Yeah.
I took video of you running in place. You didn't run around the garage. You kind of ran in place. Yeah. Like an Indian, like, rain dance or something. But I took video of it. I don't know if I ever posted it.
I think you videoed the whole episode.
That might be right.
Yeah, you did.
Okay.
And then the get on your hands and knees and say I love you, Brad, in a dog voice.
Yeah.
That was pretty funny. But the Corn Dogging of Crisis. If you guys just look at YouTube and type in Corn Dog of Crisis, it'll come up with all of Nick's other videos. And it's just the anal punishment.
Alright, so we'll go on to the next one. The lamest category. The lamest for me was on episode 15, Treasure Hunting for Nostalgia Trivia Challenge. It was the juiced onion shot that I took. I lost a close match to Brandon. The game was hosted by Brad. The game was played over at Brad's house, and we had an audience of four young men. Brandon heard that a juiced onion was the next health craze, so he tried it and found out that it made his stomach turn. Do you remember that?
Yeah, it was burning. Like, and that's the crazy thing is I juiced it along with a whole bunch of other vegetables.
Uh-huh.
So when I tried it, my stomach was burning like on fire.
And didn't say you were sweating onion smell?
Yeah, when I worked, people were like, who's eating onions? And I was like, well, I drank some onion juice earlier. And they were like, you stink.
So basically the punishment was that he would bring it to another level and make the person who lost drink a whole coffee cup full of juiced onion. Jordan, Brad's son, decided to try it with me. I tried it first for the sake of the podcast. It wasn't pleasant, but it wasn't gag-worthy. Jordan took a sip and somehow it got into his eye and
he began writhing
in pain. It was kind of amusing. But yeah, that was the lamest for me. I wasn't doing it because, like, for the same reason that Brad did it, I wasn't manning up to finish it off. Like, I actually felt like I have a bottle of liquid in front of me, and I'm thirsty, so I drank the rest of it. It was really not that bad. So that was the lamest.
That's what I had as my
nomination. That was my nomination, yeah.
Okay. So we'll go on to the most painful, and this is going to be Crisis's ass punch on Torment, episode 46, the Ultimate Warrior Tribute. To me, this punishment earns the most painful prize because both the attacker and the victim suffered mightily. The ferocity of Brandon's punch was much greater because Brad had delivered a rather violent ass punch only a few weeks prior on episode 42, Side-Scrolling Action. Brad's ass punch was good because he let out a nice shuriken, but you could tell that Brandon's was quite vindictive. Brandon paid the price and complained about wrist pain for weeks. So that's why the most painful goes to the ass punch that Torment took from Crisis on episode 46. Any other nominations or honorable mentions?
No. Well, of course, you know, the corn dog I took in Vegas, but...
That's coming up next.
Oh, man.
The best execution. Torment's corn dog on Crisis while in Las Vegas on the Sports Trivia Game Show episode 10. Torment warmed up with some tiger knees while wearing boxer shorts and a wife beater.
Taking my fashion advice from Jason Johnson.
When Brad's knee connected with Brandon's anus, Brandon's reaction was amazing. While he writhed in pain, he squealed, "It burns! It burns!" His voice had not returned to its masculine state, even when he was signing off for the podcast. What did you say? Something like, "This is for episode 10 for nostalgia. It's a bad." The impact was so severe that the damage flowed all the way to Brad's wife, Karen, who had broken her tailbone only a few hundred miles away from us. And I've noted that on the video, again, you can see this on YouTube, it was complimented by a guest appearance of Aaron, who scratched his balls while holding the microphone. I
forgot about that.
So that's the best execution for all punishments that have taken place on Treasure Hunting for Nostalgia so far. Episode 10.
That when that knee connects, you're like up in the air for like 2 seconds. And then the laugh that Nick lets out, it wasn't a laugh, it was like a it's like the best video ever.
Yeah.
And then Aaron's sitting there scratching his mouth. Pulling the microphone.
So that's all the categories I have. Take it away, Brandon.
Okay, so I'm going to do game show category. So we're going to go with funniest game show question, episode 4.
Here are the nominations.
Here are the nominations. Episode 4, King of Nostalgia. Category was 377 Mobley, Brad, Mines, and Matthew's childhood, where we grew up. The question was asked to Matt. Matt was caught dry humping this little girl when he was 2 or 3. And then, of course, he replies, Shay Shay, and that was correct. One of Brad's that was Brad's nomination, and this was another one he had. Episode 10, Sports Trivia Challenge. Category, hockey. Question, this is the black disc made of hard rubber that is a focus of play in hockey. And I believe Brad beat me to it and said, puck. Oh, I got it?
You got it.
That's right.
These are funniest questions?
Yeah. Okay. And there was only those two. I thought they were more, but I did more for answers.
So what was the winner?
Huh? The winner? Episode 4, King of Nostalgia, who Matt was caught dry humping this little girl when he was 2 or 3. She consented.
I thought she's the one who told him to do it.
To get on top. That's her story, or his story. Now we've got funniest game show answers. Episode 40.
And here are the
And here are the nominations. Episode 49, Mega Luxurious Game Show. I asked Matt, what movie scares you? In the uncut version, it took him 3.5 minutes to come up with an answer.
It did. It took him how long?
And all I was looking for was just any fucking movie name. It could have been My Little Pony. I'm like, all right, there's the points. But here,
to his defense, you don't know what to expect from your questions. They're not always straightforward like that.
That one was.
Technically, he should have gotten that point wrong.
I did.
Because he gave him a 5-second countdown. And I think it was Matt who said, oh, what do you mean by that?
Yeah, he filibustered.
Yeah, God, yes, he did.
Episode 10, Sports Trivia Challenge, or Sports Trivia Extravaganza. Category, current. Question, name one player of the San Francisco Giants roster. Of course, Brandon comes in and says, Linda cum. Nick, knowing this is wrong, Brandon, thinking he's right, says, can you give a first name? Brandon says, Barry Linda cum. That was incorrect. Episode 10, Sports Trivia Extravaganza, category current. Question, name two players of the 2013 Miami Heat roster. Answer, Brandon says, let's go Wade and Bosch. Nick says, can you give first names? Brandon, let's go LeBron James and Derek Wade.
Derek Wade.
That was incorrect.
Those two were my nominations, right?
Yeah. Episode 4, King of Nostalgia, Brad's Lightning Round question. Category, Jenny Red, Ron Ron, and their crazy friends. Question, who got shot in the back and was rendered paralyzed? The answer, Wheelchair Tony. Episode 10, Sports Trivia Extravaganza, History. Who had the most career home runs? Sammy Sosa. Answered by Brandon.
I was going to say Sammy Sosa too, but you said it first.
And the winner is Episode 10, Sports Trivia Extravaganza, current category current. Name one player of the San Francisco Giants roster. Lindicum. Can you please give a name? Barry Lindicum. What makes it so funny is I seriously thought that was his name. And it's Tim Lincecum.
Yep, that's right.
And I was going to say Kirkpatrick.
Yeah.
Which I thought was a quarterback of the 49ers.
Yeah. Okay. Worst game show question. Here are the nominations. Episode 20, Bringing Sexy Back. Category, activities. Brandon asks, what specific item is on the curtains hanging in Dell's treehouse? Obviously, the answer is electric guitars. Episode 45, This, That, and the Shockmaster. Brad says, true or false? All vaginas taste the same.
Category.
Category?
Sex ed.
Sex ed.
No. Say it again.
Sex ed.
No. Category.
The category is sex ed. True or false? All vaginas taste the same. Nick answers false. Brad says, I don't know the answer to that question. But I'm going to agree with you. Episode 30, Twisted Shame. Category? Brad knows. Question? Any fucking Brad knows question. Examples. This is the best ice cream flavor of all time. The answer was fucking Cherry Garcia. What? Another example. What is the best pizza chain? I said Mountain Mike's, but of course it was Round Table for their Maui Zowie. Another Brad knows question. Jesse and the Rippers or Metallica? That's like comparing apples to oranges. And then another one. Best superhero. Matt says Venom. Brad says, ooh, close. Something in Spider-Man. But then I was like, no, Batman. He's like, yep, that's right. And the winner is all of Brad knows from episode 30, Twisted Shame.
Scarred you for life. There might be a repeat of that category. Oh,
man. And then we have the best game show. Here are our nominations. Episode 30, Twisted Shame. This was probably one of the most scarring moments of my life.
Your life?
Of my life. Running around naked with three young boys watching me, laughing and pointing.
You were cupping your genitals.
I was cupping my genitals, but I had just shaven like the day before.
You did. Oh, Unibrow. Unibrow. You're like, oh, I have no hair.
So I had to in one of the, well, I don't know what it was, a box maybe.
What's in the box?
Matt and I had to shave our genitals, but I thought I got out because I'd shaved the day before.
Like everything. You shaved, yeah. Even your toes.
So I got to use some of Matt's pubic hair on my plate.
Yeah, and they had to super or crazy glue pubic hair and make a unibrow.
And so another moment. I had to kiss Nick's butt for 7 seconds. The kid said a minute, but I think we said 7 seconds. And that caused Nick to have his pet trousers down the whole rest of the game show. Yeah. And then Karen comes in and Nick has his pants around his ankle and Matt and I have pubic hair all over her face. And then Nick said, I could explain. Because Karen's like, what's going on here?
And then you had to call mom.
Oh, yeah, I did have to call mom.
Tell her you had herpes.
Yeah, and she took. She thought I was so serious. She said I should get it checked out. Sports trivia extravaganza. This made my list because it's the one category that Brad and I know nothing about. And we tried like hell, but couldn't pull through. Brad did, but...
If it wasn't for that cross-checking answer. I don't know how I got that.
That was crazy.
And the whole build-up to it, I was like sitting there panicking halfway through it thinking I was going to lose because I didn't know.
Like, you had just given up, and I was in the lead by like 12 points.
And then I finally made a comeback. My favorite part of that game show was the final question when we had to write down
Current NBA players.
And you put down Danny Ainge.
He's the first one that came to mind.
And I said, he doesn't play anymore. Like I was superior. But I think I put down
John Stockton and Carmelo.
Carmelo, because I thought they still played.
And then final, Heaven and Hell. This is a winner here. Though I just put so much time into this one, I had to give it the win. I put together everything for these guys that I wanted to do, like a scavenger hunt. That seemed heck of fun to do. Morphing time in the Kmart or Target, wherever you guys did it.
Walmart. And Duke was too proud to do it.
Oh, man. Didn't he say he had to record? He was a recorder?
No. He straight up walked away. We had to prop the recording thing up on the shelf.
What's up with that?
He was just, like, not down for it at all.
Everything else, though, huh?
Yep, everything else.
Having you guys run around a retard school looking for...
Oh, man. I thought you were the one that didn't say that word.
That's true. I should only say it when I say someone's retarded and not mentally handicapped, but those people were mentally handicapped. Running around a mentally handicapped adult school...
Oh.
Looking for clues and items.
At night. That was cool.
Black lights. That was pretty cool. I still have them. Now we have creme de la creme.
Basically, these categories have nothing to do with our previous categories. They're not lumped in with treasure hunting, top fives, are basically not lumped into our main show. These are just all different types of categories.
First category on the list. Awkward moments.
Most awkward moment?
Yeah. Greatest awkward moment, and here are the nominees. Episode 20, or episode 23, Comic Relieved, during Brandon's Game of the Week of his inspired Tale of Destiny game, Brad let one rip quite loud. And quite distracting.
Brandon got heck of a
I couldn't stop laughing. I had a fit of the giggles.
Yeah. And so after about 30 seconds of Brad giggling and Brandon trying to get through his game of the week, Brandon says, "Dude, can you stop?" And I was heck of super serious.
No, because we were just talking about the sword that could talk, and I just couldn't hold it anymore. So I was thinking about the sword fart talking.
Episode 9, Have Mercy. Life Goes On. Brad says, remember when Corky wanted to drive a car one time and said, you can't drive a car, you're too retarded. He then crashed the car and had a tard freak out. And then later on in the discussion, I said, you remember when he slept in bed with that one girl? And you say, no. Oh, wait, the other retarded girl? And then episode 38, Shoryuken, the death of Andy Pilato.
Oh, man.
Karen was on that one, and you were just, like, so adamant on just belittling Andy Pilato and talking about his suicide.
It's not my fault he's in hell right now.
Oh, man.
And the winner is episode 38, Shoryuken, death of Andy Pilato. Karen still have that quarter?
I don't think so. Oh. If she does, I threw it away. It's probably haunted. Need to get rid of it.
Best sentimental moment. Episode 1 and 2 nomination from Brad, where we discuss our most nostalgic games of all time. I think it's we should do that again. Do a remap.
That would be heck of awesome with Nick doing it.
Yeah. Episode 20, Bringing Sexay Back, another Brad nomination, The Treasure Trove that we found in Folsom. Episode 9, Have Mercy, getting our sponsorship from Tell 'Em Steve Dave. And then final one, episode 7, Grip It and Rip It, finding our third member. And the winner is finding our third host. Episode 7, Grip It and Rip It.
Aww. Where is this most sentimental?
Sentimental.
Aww. It is truly sentimental. Thank you.
Funniest moment. Episode 14, Treasure Hunters Gone Wild, Brad's crazy bachelor party story.
I just thought it was funny how all the kids, well, most of us were 18, some were 17, went to the ATM so we had enough money to pay for the stripper, the toy show. And she's like standing around, like waiting for him to get back. And she was like, this is the lowest I ever done this for.
It was about 75?
I think 60.
Oh, man. And I remember I was like, Adrian will be able to pay for it because he was always bragging about how much money he had all the time. But he had to culminate with all the other...
Well, we know he was a poser in high school now.
Yeah.
With his long old beard.
Is he back with Jennifer Crockett? The only reason I asked is because I thought I saw her at Target and someone who looked just like him. Like, I don't know if they're... No. Oh.
No, that is not accurate.
I hate to offend Adrian Contreras.
I don't have any sympathy for him because he is friends with Brad Ward, and I hate that guy. Guess some people just like getting DUIs.
Episode 26. What was this about again? Brad throwing his tooth on the table, and Nick going, ugh! Episode 3, Goons, Goats, and Grey Gold, Brad's realization that Aki was deaf. That was hilarious because he was like,
He had a speech problem.
Yeah, he had his, like, he talked like, blah, 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 blah. And then, like, oh, he was probably deaf. You're like, oh. Then I have on here, cool pics.
Yes.
And then episode 36, the games, well, it's pretty much 34 through 38, where we just bash GameStop employees and have interviews with Chris. And to me, the funniest moment was Brad throwing the tooth on his table.
Nice.
Next, we have Best Guest. We have episode 38, Karen. She was on Shoryuken. Episode 44, Final Fantasy XXX, we had Melissa Jones. We had Tim Wilson on episode 35 and 49. We had Maddie G on episode 24 and for some game shows. Brian Gerwer made his appearance, episode 49. Logan, Sam, and Jordan, along with Willie on episode 20, Bringing Sexy Back, or is that the Trivia Challenge? They were on the Trivia Challenge?
Trivia Challenge.
Episode 15, Trivia Challenge. Al Van, episode 24 and 25. And Chris, episode 36, 37. Can I see your phone? I'm going to call the winner and have them give an acceptance speech.
Aaron was our guest host.
Oh, he too. Was.
He actually came and sat in my place one time, too.
For the character battle.
And he didn't make the list, because I forgot.
You can always... Oh, that's too late to add him. That might be too close.
Hey, Tim.
Yeah?
This is Treasure Hunting for Nostalgia. How are you doing? We have Brandon here, and Brad, and Brad. Nick. And Nick. We're doing our award ceremony, and you had just won for best guest. Would you like to give an acceptance speech?
Sure. Am I doing it right now?
Yes, you are.
I guess it was a part of an acceptance speech to say now, keeping the current trend of my appearance.
Thank you for listening, and thank you for being a guest on the show.
Congratulations!
Yeah.
All right, bye.
Well, I'll listen to this one because Nick's going to be on it.
All right, sounds good.
Bye.
All right, bye.
I'd like to challenge that. That nomination.
Yeah, Tim's been saying episode 24 was his favorite episode because Nick wasn't on it.
24 or 34? 34 was Christmas, yeah.
That's pretty funny.
Yeah, he's a jerk. I like him, though.
So you have more than one winner?
Yeah. I just thought it would be funny to call different people and get their acceptance speech.
Who are you calling now?
You'll see. Mm-hmm. Hello?
Hey, what's up?
Is this Brian Gerwer?
Yeah.
This is Treasure Hunting for Nostalgia.
How are you doing?
You have just won. We're doing our award ceremony, and you have just won Best Guest for Treasure Hunting for Nostalgia.
Sweet.
Based solely on
performance.
When your brother said 8. And then someone else said, "No, no, that's fine." And then you say 10.
Sweet.
So, would you like to give an acceptance speech?
You know, I was very grateful to be invited to be over, and And, you know, I just thought that in that Shockmaster game, you kind of just had to put it down and take your punishment. And, you know, I realized the punishment wasn't as severe for me. So I, there might be a new anchor strategy.
All right, well, sounds good. Even though Matty G didn't get his punishment as much as he should have, you sure was trying to give it to him.
Yeah, well, he knew a lot more than he thought, too. Like, because I was reviewing the podcast, there was a bunch of times where he was like, oh, I knew that, oh, I knew that. And I think that if he would have accepted it a little bit more often, he might have gotten some more points and not finished it.
All right, well, thank you for your time, Brian, and we will talk to you later.
Thank you.
All right, bye.
Bye.
I never got it on video, but we should have got it on video how he took the punishment. It was so fucking funny.
Yeah, it was. Matt. Hello, is this Matthew Chavez?
Yes.
This is Treasure Hunting for Nostalgia. And we are doing our awards ceremony, and you have just won the category Best Guest.
Really?
How would you like to give an acceptance speech?
Sure.
What was that?
Is there like a certain guest that I need that maybe witness
or? No, you're just awesome. No, not guest. Guest.
Oh, guest.
Yeah.
Oh, gotcha. Okay, well then I'm like the better hunting for the dog before inviting me to the game shows as a special guest. And, you know, it's always been fun every time I go and record with you guys.
Awesome. I don't think we have any, you guys have any questions?
No.
What are you doing? Hey, I have a question. This is Brad.
Okay.
Why did you hump Shay Shay that one day?
Really? Oh, God. That was like over 20 years ago.
Brad wants to know whose idea it was. Hers or yours? Yeah, lights were down. Was she holding your hand walking towards the bedroom? Awesome. All right, well, congratulations and enjoy the rest of your Sunday. All right, bye.
Is that all you're calling?
Yeah.
So that was a three-way tie?
Yeah. Best fan, Tim Wilson.
For, and the nominees are.
And the nominees are Tim Wilson for downloading every one of our podcasts and listening to them. Zachary McDaniel for just being an awesome fan and contributing his top five list to us whenever we post him up there. Brian Gerwer, new to the bandwagon, but it's good to see that he's listening to him, catching up. Heath Ellenberg, listening to every one of our podcasts back to back when he heard it on Tell 'Em Steve Dave. Jordan Bartholomew for creating our new image, and so we won't have copyright infringement. And our winner is Jordan Bartholomew, and he will be giving an acceptance speech shortly.
Tell him to go somewhere quiet because you know he's probably sitting in the playroom with everybody.
They could hear the And you have his cell phone on here?
Please leave your message.
Is that his cell phone?
916.
Oh, yeah, that's his. It was under Jordan?
Mm hmm.
That's probably his cell phone. You have to type in home. The kid never answered his cell phone. The phone rings in that house, everyone goes wild.
Is Karen home now? Hey, Karen. This is Brandon. Hey, can I talk to Jordan real quick? Okay. Okay. We're 0 for 2 on that. Alright, thanks. Bye. So, if they call back...
They're not going to call back. You have to call them.
Okay. And this is where the pod cut off. For some reason, the rest of this podcast did not record. Oh, by the way, this is Brandon, by the way. So what we had was a pretty good acceptance speech from Jordan for winning Best Fan for creating our image that we use. We also discussed what we wanted to do for the next 50 shows. Brad had said, just you wait till episode 100, and that's all he said. He didn't divulge anything to the audience, Nick, or myself, so hopefully he's not blowing wind, and he has something awesome planned. So that'll do it for episode 50 of Treasure Hunting for Nostalgia. This is Brandon.
This is Brad.
This is Nick. Happy hunting, guys.